Ashita, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Savitar School of Engineering. In this video session, we are going to see about the Environment Protection Act 1986. So before going too deep into the session, first we can see the what are the points we are going to learn and under this topic. Rules to regulate environment pollution, prevention, control and abatement of environmental pollution, environmental laboratories, qualification of government analyst, functions of environmental laboratories, penalty and conclusion. First we can see about the introduction of Environment Protection Act. Environment Protection Act is introduced in the year 1986 and introduced by the Parliament of India. In the wake of the Bhopal gas tragedy or Bhopal disaster, the Government of India enacted the Environment Protection Act of 1986 under the Article 253 of the Constitution. This act is passed in March 1986 and it came into force on 19th November 1986. The objectives are to protect the forest and wildlife in the country, to improve the quality of life by protection of environment, to coordinate the activities of the various regulatory agencies already in existence, to appoint environment officers to check environmental pollution, establishing environmental laboratories. So these are the various objectives. Then we can move on to the sources and causes for the pollution. Combustion, construction, mining, agriculture, chemical plants, coal-fired power plants, oil refineries, petrochemical plants, nuclear waste, large livestock farms, PVC factories, plastics factories are all the various sources and causes for the pollution. Then we can see the central board and the state board and who are the members of central board. The first member of the central board is the chairman and then the representative of the central government. It should not exceed 5. The representative of state government, it should not exceed 5. Representative of companies or corporations owned, controlled or managed by the central government, it should be minimum of 2. And representative have interest of agriculture, fishery or industry or trade, etc. And it should not exceed 3. And the member secretary. Then the officers. The central government may appoint officers with such designation as it thinks fits for the purposes of this act and may entrust to them such of the powers and functions under this act as it may deem fit. Then we can move on to the powers of the central government. Laying down standards for the quality of environment in its various aspects, planning and execution of a nationwide program for the prevention, control, abatement of environmental pollution, laying down standards for emission or discharge of environmental pollutants from various sources, restrictions of areas, laying down procedures and safeguards for the handling of hazardous substances, examination of such manufacturing processes, materials and substances which are likely to cause environmental pollution, then inspection of any premises, plant, equipment, machinery, manufacturing or other processes, materials and substances, establishment or recognition of environmental laboratories and institutes, collection and dissemination of information in respect of matters relating to environmental pollution, preparation of manuals or guides relating to the prevention, control and abatement of environmental pollution. Then we can move on to the rules to regulate environment pollution. The central government may by notification in the official gazette make rules in respect of all or any of the matters referred to in section 3. The standards of quality of air, water or soil for various areas and purposes. The maxima allowable limits of concentration of various environmental pollutants for different areas. The procedures and safeguards for the handling of hazardous substances. The prohibition and restrictions on the handling of hazardous substances in different areas, the prohibition and restriction on the location of industries and the carrying on process and operations in different areas, the procedures and safeguards for the prevention of accidents which may cause environmental pollution and for providing for remedial measures for such accidents. Then we can move on to prevention, control and abatement of environmental pollution. Persons carrying on industry operations etc. are not to allow emission or discharge of environmental pollutants in excess of the standards. Persons handling hazardous substance to comply with procedural safeguards, furnishing of information to authorities and agencies in certain cases, powers of entry and inspection, power to take sample and procedure to be followed in connection therewith.